Gwyn Margaret, Cian Corrigan. Taoiseach, tá lán soirnig faoi cuid mhór brú ag an uair deacair seo, agus tá sé mar seo le blianta anois. An cibann leat an t-éithin, an cibann leat dá five-point plán, dúirt tú go bhfuil dá rialtas ar slí difear, bé difear mór idir Fine Gael, Labour, agus Fianna Fáil. Agus dúirt tú go mbeidh tú machanta le soirnigh, so sin an céad ceist, Taoiseach. Your government's austerity programme is causing huge hardship. Austerity, I think, it's very clear to see, is not working. 500,000 unemployed, tens of thousands emigrating, families struggling to pay bills. Now, under your austerity programme, this is going to continue for a further 3 years, and there will be another 8.6 billion in cuts and tax increases. So, Taoiseach, citizens want to know where is this money to come from? Where are you going to get the money to pay for the guards and the nurses and the public services and all the rest of it? How are you going to pay?
Sorry, please.
How are you going to pay for this austerity treaty? And Taoiseach, would you please tell the citizens the real cost of this treaty and how your government is going to pay for it, and how many more cuts or tax increases, household charges, septic tank charges, all the rest of it are going to be introduced to pay for your austerity, particularly when austerity clearly is not working?
Thank you, Deputy Taoiseach.
Cúpnú gomáirin ar an plán cúig pointe bhí agin ag ar báitir ibh an tááchán, agus cúpnú gomáirin tááchán, agus cúpnú na nithe agus na rudaí bhí tú héna cáin siúha, agus cúpnú gomáir an siúd, agus tú ar rá gomáir difriartáin idir múj héna agus páitir an rásúra. Is cinnte gúil neart pointe difriúla an, agus an taobh sin de. Tá sead gomáid go raibh gúil an ara airgeadais i dean gháil agus i díospóireachtaí lena chóileachí san Eorop ó thaobh áirithe gon plán a bhí leacha amach leis a troicha agus gúil athrú tucu i gceist acu siúd agus tás agat go liúme iad seo hana seo sa dáil. You always speak of austerity. Yesterday you said that it was quite bizarre that discussions or comments should be made between myself and Deputy Martin in respect of supporting this fiscal stability treaty because of its the clear opportunity to keep confidence levels for investment in Ireland very high. Now, as we're here in the Dáil today, the Minister for Jobs and Enterprise and Innovation is actually in the United States with the Industrial Development Authority, talking to a range of companies who are considering investing in Europe. And the reason that they want to consider Ireland is because of the package that Ireland offers in terms of our tax situation, our technological capacity, our talent, and our track record in meeting every objective and bar that's been set. And you have first-hand evidence of that yourself in your own town in Dundalk, in your own constituency, where PayPal decided to put in 1,000 jobs. Now, you found the discussions that I had in the comments of Deputy Martin yesterday quite bizarre. I don't understand that. But I think what I should say to you, Deputy Adams, is that every job that's created in the country here as a result of investment from abroad reduces our deficit by 20,000. So 1,000 jobs announced, 1,000 jobs announced is a 20 million reduction. 5,000 is a 100 million reduction. I've announced these because of decisions made by investors abroad in the recent past, like PayPal, Apple, Cisco, Eli Lilly, Mylan, Microsoft, HP, and so on. And these have made decisions to invest their money in various locations in this country where people will be able to be employed, have gainful employment and can make a gainful contribution to their local economy, their own lives and their own families. And that's not austerity. Now, we have set out our programme for growth and a plan for growth to deal with our budgetary strategy over the years ahead. But it is very important that people in this country understand the reality that a yes vote leads to confidence and further investment and, as a consequence, further jobs. And that means, Deputy Adams, that the deficit is lowered and it's easier for government to plan a way forward between rectifying our public finances, stabilising our debt and growing our economy here. So I don't accept the argument that you put forward at all. And in fact, there are very good reasons for voting yes in this treaty. First is the continuation of the line of investment in here. Second is the introduction of good housekeeping rules if we get our own house in order. And third is the backstop, the permanent backstop of the European Stability Mechanism available to countries ratify the treaty. And those companies in the United States today who are considering investment in Europe want to look at a country that has confidence in itself, confidence in the Eurozone, and confidence in the European Union, and that's where we stand. And whether your heart is not in this argument at all, you know, first-hand evidence in Dundalk, investors put their money where their mouth is, in your constituency, in your town, and young men and young women will be the gainful beneficiaries of that, and fair play to them.
Thank you. Deputy Adams.
Well, Taoiseach, I welcomed and I also commended the government. Any new jobs coming in are obviously very, very good. And like others in the Sinn Féin ranks, we work to try and bring jobs into our constituencies. Now, Taoiseach, you ignored the question.
Sorry, please.
I asked you how you were going to pay for this treaty. You already have to find 8.6 billion in cuts in taxes. There's an additional 6 billion if the people are tricked or bullied by your Minister for Hardship and others into voting yes. And Taoiseach, you've also failed to tell people. You've failed to tell people that we have to pay 11 billion into the ESM. And yes, I did find it bizarre to listen to you and Jacques de Martin discussing this issue, because this is the party which has caused the economic collapse on the one hand, and Chuck de Martin can't even persuade his own party to vote yes. So I did think it was bizarre sitting here listening to the two of you chatting.
Thank you. Could we have
the question?
And
what both you have in common is that you are on the same road. No talk now about your five-point plan. No talk except rhetoric about job stimulus, because this is where Sinn Féin parts company with the rest of you. You cannot cut your way out of recession.
We're over time.
I'll say it again. You cannot cut your way out of recession. There needs to be jobs. People need to be taken off the dole, and this austerity treaty will cost the taxpayers more than they're having to pay at this point in time. So, Taoiseach, answer the question. How will you find all these billions to pay for this treaty?
Thank you.
I'm delighted to hear Deputy Adams is interested in seeing that the Gardaí and the nurses and the teachers be paid. There was a time when you didn't have that interest in the Gardaí, I must say, in the past. Now, we've set out our budgetary plan. We were in a programme for 2 years. Under the excessive deficit procedure, we want to have our deficit down to 3% by 2015. I do not accept your argument about 6 billion beyond that, because there's a corrective period beyond 2015 where the methodologies that can be put forward by Ireland and will be put forward by Ireland will deal with that issue, because we want as many people off the live register as possible and in gainful employment. And the figures for the live register for April this year stand at 430,000, which is much too high. It represents a decrease of over 4,000 in the month and a decrease of 9,500 in the year. See, the figure is much too high. But as I've said to you, Deputy, every job that's created in this country reduces our deficit by 20,000. And the continued stream of investment in here is very important. Now, since you began your career in politics, you and your party have opposed every single European treaty, every single European referendum. You don't believe You don't believe in the Eurozone. You don't believe in the Euro. You do not believe in the European Union. You don't believe, actually, if you follow your own logic, that companies abroad should invest in this country and should put 1,000 jobs up in your own town. What kind of political philosophy have you got there? I recognise, as everybody else does, that austerity or cutbacks are never a way to prosperity. But you have to balance your books, and treaty or no treaty, we have to balance our own public finances here. I want you to understand, Deputy Adams,
Please.
The European Central Bank, as you know, have put 150 billion in liquidity into the Irish system. The government have set out its projections for growth and our views on no taxes, no further taxes on employment and upon work. This treaty is not a panacea for all Europe's problems. It's not a panacea for all. It is one of the tools that are needed to restore stability, bring back competitiveness, and to bring about employment and social cohesion. That's why we've always been upfront with the people in saying that, in parallel with this, you do need the agenda of growth and investment and opportunity. And that's where this government is focused, and that's where we have convinced our European colleagues at leadership level that this should apply for every meeting of the European Council in future.
Thank you.
I support, as I said yesterday, every other leader who is now saying we need a parallel growth and investment strategy so that jobs can be created.
Thank you.
I recognise, as you do, that when other economies in Europe are thriving, it's good for Ireland as an exporting nation because they can buy our products and buy our goods, and that means jobs and job creation and investment and opportunities here at home.
Thank you. Deputy Boyle Barrett.